isn't even really a disclaimer, but you don't have to follow trends, okay? You don't have to spend like $5,000 on an item and then never wear it again because it becomes no longer trendy, which is why I like to do like a three-part series where in the second video, I will be actually thrifting the trends for cheaper. And then in the third video, I will be styling them just to show you guys how you can wear them. And then in this one, I just kind of talk about it. I don't know, I feel like it's a good way to get inspired. I mean, honestly, that's why I love trends, because it gets me inspired to wear new things. So I'm not constantly wearing like the same thing over and over again. This video is not gonna be like how I usually do my trends, because normally I would split it up and do like spring, summer, and then do a fall, winter. And obviously it's only January, like we're still kind of with the trends that were from winter of last year. So instead, what I decided to do to kind of kick it off, this is definitely not runway inspired. It could be runway inspired actually technically from the 2020 runways, but this is not gonna be 2021. So if you're looking at this, don't look at me and be like, this stupid bitch doesn't even know what she's talking about, and like these are definitely not like what Vogue or whatever said, because this is not it. This is just stuff that I decided to look at when it came to the stores, a bunch of like different Instagram influencers and things like that, and just kind of what I saw. Trend that I want to talk about is dark brown leather. It was the Revolve corset. I actually don't know if it was from Revolve, but you know, it was on the website of Revolve, and it is this brown leather corset. It is sold out now, but it's just that specific type of brown. I saw so many people style it, and then when I was looking at all the different websites and stuff, I just saw so much dark brown leather. Leather, first off, is always in. It's just like in different varieties, but it's always been like black leather. Like when I think brown leather, I literally think my grandpa. Like I think an old man wearing a brown leather coat, and now I just see it in so many cute variations. Like I want, like when we do the whole thrifting video, which will be the next video, I really wanna find brown leather pants. I just want them like nice and flared. It might be a little bit hard to find because I am 5'1", so I'm super short, but that is definitely the goal. Also a nice brown handbag. I don't have it here with me right now. You'll see in the styling video, or hopefully maybe even the thrifting video, but I thrifted this brown leather purse not too long ago, and I am obsessed with it. This next trend is definitely something that was a trend last year, but I feel like it was not, like you couldn't really find it in a lot of places unless you went to the thrift store, and also I didn't see that many people style it as I do now, and it is the knitted vest. You would have seen them so much over a white collared shirt, especially in the fall time. Again, I love TikTok so much because there's just so much good style inspiration, and the amount of people that I have seen on there styling a knitted vest is so cute. Even if you just go to websites and you look at all the different vests that they're selling, again, you could find them anywhere now. You don't just have to go to the thrift store now, but as you guys know, I just love paying like $2 for a vest or something instead of, again, spending like $50, because you never know, you might not really like the trend. So that's why I like to do the thrifting portion, so you're not like spending so much money. But yeah, I just think that's probably one of my most favorite trends, because you can go so many different routes, because you can do a knitted vest, you could do just like a normal simple vest. I actually just thrifted a black one. It's kind of like a stretchy material, so it doesn't have like that sweater vibe to it, but it's still, I feel like, was really cute. So this doesn't just have to be geared towards knitted. And then again, when it came to the runways, pretty much the only one that I saw that I looked at was Louis Vuitton, and they did a good job of like styling it, especially with the tones that they were using, Argyle. I mean, it was literally everywhere, all over fall and winter. It was just like throwing up, and very popular in the form of actually the sweater vest, or you know, you could do a whole sweater thing like this. I definitely thrifted this one. You could find so much Argyle at the thrift. Honestly, Depop, great for it. I actually have some Argyle up on my Depop if you guys are interested. I actually just started watching Real Housewives of New York, and within like the first couple episodes, one of the daughters was wearing an Argyle sweater that literally looks exactly like this. And of course, you know, New York, it's like all in the Upper East Side and all of that, so it definitely gives me major Gossip Girl vibes like when I do think of Argyle. However, now it doesn't just have to be preppy anymore. I feel like it's transitioning into the spring and summer now. I didn't just see it on sweater vests. I didn't just see it on normal sweaters. Literally, I've been seeing it when I went on the stores. I saw it in the form of freaking skirts, just normal shirts. Like, it's literally gonna be throwing up on everything now. The last one that's kind of still transitioning is gonna be patchwork. In previous trends videos, I've definitely talked about how patch was one of the trends, but I think like back in the day when I did, it was more of just like a denim jacket and just like a couple of random patches. But now it's like the entire garment is patched. I actually just found this girl on YouTube, and she did this DIY pants in, of course, what color? In the color brown. I literally found her last night when I was just sleeping and I couldn't sleep, and I was just like up and crazy. I'm gonna link that video down below, and it definitely makes me wanna get my sewing machine back out. She of course went to the thrift store, got all the pants, so maybe that's what we'll do also. But it's kind of like a good segue into, it's no longer, you know, just like where you see, again, like I said, denim jacket, just random patches. It's now like the entire thing is patched, like the pants. And again, you could go to the thrift store, get a bunch of fabric, DIY your own. I feel like that's so good to get something unique, something cool, and you could really like pick different fabrics and things like that. It used to just be mainly on denim. Like, I know Moschino had these pants, I'll just put them up so you can see, but now it's like everything. It's not just the denim. Like, I just think it's so freaking cool. Literally, Dolce's entire, like, when I say entire runway, and this is for 2021, entire runway was patched. Like, every single thing just had some type of patchwork. It was absolutely bizarre, but like in the best way. Now, this next trend, I have no idea what to call it. It is the off stitch, but it's raised. I mean, I have so many examples. I saw it everywhere, so I'm just gonna let the photos do the talking, but I specifically saw it so much in mesh. Like, that is just, it's like literally mesh is throwing up all over the stitching. It's not something that's hard to find at all. Like, you can go on any website, and yeah, I feel like there's not really much else to say because it's not anything really specific, because you can literally find it in anything. Now, this trend kind of ties in with exactly what I was just talking about with the off stitching, because you could actually see it in a lot of these pieces, which is funky mesh, like skin tight mesh. And mesh, I feel like, is always popular every year, whether it's just like the classic nude, or a couple years ago it was the like clouds with the cherubs. You always see like some form of it. Then it was animal print. This year it's just like funky mesh. Just, I don't know how to describe it. It's just a bunch of, like, think of it where it's so much going on that you don't even have to wear a bra or like anything underneath, because usually when you wear something mesh, you have to wear something under, or you're gonna literally see your nipples. This is actually something that I don't have in my closet. I have so many mesh shirts, but I don't really have anything funky or crazy, so that is definitely something that I need to manifest at the thrift. I don't know what kind of pattern or what I want. This is me kind of like stretching, okay? This is me just giving like a far stretch. This might not be true, but again, this is just what I saw in the stores. Again, I don't know how to say it, so I'm just gonna say a funky retro print. And I did see it on Princess Polly and stuff, you know, the more 70s type tones, but I also did see like a ton of bright, absurd colors. And I mean, some of them even kind of have like a zebra vibe to them, but I do see it actually when I was looking on websites in a lot of sets, which is what I like, because I always love buying a set, because it's like you can create so many different outfits. You could wear it together, or you can wear them separately and just do so much with them. So, you know, when trends just come and go, but usually you have like a good in between. Like, the early 2000s are just now, you know, deciding to come back. This is a trend that was very popular when I was like high school, and maybe like a little bit getting out of high school, and honestly even middle school. Okay, I don't even know when this was popular, but I just resonated with me still being like 16, 17, so it still kind of makes me cringe. And it is the checkerboard print. I don't know why, but for some reason I feel like it's just coming back a little bit way too soon. You know, I did see Gucci do a little bit something with it, but again, it's one of those things that I didn't really see it on the runways for 2021, and again, obviously it wasn't popular in 2020. However, if you look at any like prediction, people are just saying checkerboard. And it's not even like the checkerboard, it's actually it's like a very warped type of checkerboard, like very colorful. I mean, you could do, you know, the classic Vans skater type. And I just think, I don't know, again, it's kind of making me cringe, like, oh, like, do I want to wear it? But then again, like I said, I love trends because it makes me wear new things, so I'm not wearing the same thing over and over again. So the last two things are gonna be two accessories. I mean, there's so many accessories that are gonna be, you know, thing, but I figured I would just hit the top two ones. Again, pretty big in 2020, but are transitioning into 2021. The first one is definitely gonna be the thick pearls, and specifically I want to say more in the necklaces. Vivienne Westwood definitely is the one that I feel like just completely put the pearls on the market. Like, after I saw that, I had to go out and actually thrift one. I now wear it with all my gold jewelry, and I just feel like it makes everything look so much cuter. So I love that different accent, so it's not just all gold. Now you'll really see people, if they layer gold jewelry, they're gonna have some type of a pearl with it. And also Revolve, on their website, I forgot the brand, but I'll still put it up, they have this necklace on there where it's like thick pearls, right? But then the other half is chain, and then in the middle it has an initial, and it literally is so freaking cute. But it's like $200. It is so expensive, but I just need that necklace in my life. And then this next one, I mean, I feel like it's gonna be such a given, it's gonna be the thick headband. Very solid, whether you want to do white, nude, or black. I haven't really seen much of a printed ones just yet, but who knows, we'll maybe see it. I did see it on some websites, and you could easily find those freaking headbands probably at Walmart, or I don't know, any sporting store, obviously. Surprisingly, I still have not gotten one. I did get a wig, though, that has a built-in headband that I wear, but I wish it was just, like, a little bit longer, which kind of sucks. I will be most likely doing, you know, a spring and summer trends video, so that is based off the runways, so completely new things and stuff like that. But hopefully, this inspired you guys to get out there, go thrift, find some trends. Again, I will be doing a part two of me actually going out and thrifting them, and then I will be doing a third one where I will be styling them. But yeah, I'm very excited. I love these videos because they just get me so pumped of changing up my style. And yeah, I guess I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.